Notion's never gonna have recurring tasks. That's how I feel, at least. It's been so many years that it's probably not gonna happen. But thanks to a nice video that I actually found and I wanna give a shout out to, Automate Notion with Joe Goodman, you can actually do recurring tasks in Notion. There's a nice little neat trick that I'm going to dive right into in this video to show you how you can create automated recurring tasks in Notion. Once again, I wanna give full credit to Automate Notion with Joe Goodman for this as he found it, and I'm just relaying the information to you. So we have a basic table here that is going to be an example for recurring tasks, and he actually provided a nice template for this as well. So if we go into this Google Sheet here, and this basically is broken out with what the last due date was, how often it's supposed to recur, when is the next due date. So this task build date subtracts D3 from E3, so it takes that next due date and subtracts it from the build days before column there. And then if this F3 were to be today, so if this were to be February 14th, this would show as true, but since it's the 18th, this is false. So the next thing you wanna do is go into this website called Integromat, and it's actually free. So for the pricing on this, you'll actually see that you get 1,000 operations a month and you'll get 15 minute intervals on it. So if I sign up for this, I can actually get it for 1,000 options for free. So then after you sign up, just go to apps and services, and then you're gonna wanna connect Google Sheets and Notion. So if you go in there and press create new scenario, so press the blue plus button, look up Google Sheets, then you would go to the search rows function and then add the connection here. So continue my Google connection, sign in through the Google Sheets account that you have the template on, then select the spreadsheet. So mine's gonna be Notion recurring task template. Now you can pick what sheet it is. And as you can see on this page, there's gonna be an Integromat and recurring task page. So you're gonna wanna pick the Integromat recurring task page and then filter it so that trigger today is equal to true, and then you can press okay. And then you're gonna add another module, and that is going to be Notion. If you select Notion here, then you're going to want to click create a database item. So add a connection here that's your Notion account. So I'm gonna use this Notion internal. So what you're gonna have to do is go to the Notion integrations, and you're gonna have to make a new integration. So this is gonna be for Integromat, submit, and then you're going to have to copy this internal integration token and paste it in here. So then if I press continue, now it's not gonna be a public database, it can be private. Now what you're gonna wanna do to make sure that this connects is that you're gonna wanna add this Integromat to the database itself, right? So if I go and press share, add integrations, Integromat, invite, then it's gonna allow that connection to go through. So after a while, after you do that search, I did recurring tasks in there, it'll pop up the database ID. So then you're gonna have to select the fields. So you're gonna wanna take the name of task A from Google Sheets. We want that checkbox to be set to no, and then we want the start time to be set to the next due date. Then we want the include time to be no, since this is not going to have any functionality regarding the time of day it is. And then we're gonna press okay. So now we're gonna have to do one more step and use Integromat for the multi-step functionality of it, as Joe talked about in his video, because obviously we have that next due date that needs to change after the first one is done. So then we're gonna have to go back to that Google Sheet. Then we're gonna have to update that cell. So the cell that we're gonna update is in that Notion recurring task template in the Integromat recurring tasks. Essentially what we're gonna want to happen here is we're gonna have this get copied over to this. So D3 to copy over to B3, because we wanna keep this updating as the recurring tasks keep happening. So we'd go back into Integromat, but then we're gonna actually just keep it as just B, and then we want the row number of the very first module. So that being this module. Then we're going to select column D here for next due date, because it's gonna update D3 by doing this. Then we're gonna press okay. And if we go into here, we can see it actually created the recurring task. So I can actually run this one more time to show you in a side-by-side. So as can be seen, if I change this back to 217 and run it again, it creates that recurring task. And then what it does is it updates it to have it be 7 days later, and the next due date would be there. So then all you'd have to do then is actually turn this on and have it set to whatever interval that you'd like. It would search the rows and say what triggers are true, and then it would run it if that was the case. And you'd have recurring tasks in Notion.
If you like this video, make sure to check out this one to see how you can improve your Notion even more.